Hi and welcome back to another tutorial of the series How to Create Endos and City Prompts in Blender 2.82. This is BulletTuber with the 11th tutorial on how to create these barriers and texture them after that in Substance Painter. So let's start and I hope you enjoy it. So let's start with the first barrier that we are going to create. First, we are going to model all the barriers that we need and then texture them in Substance Painter. So let's model everything first and export them as FBX files. So the first one will be a cylinder that I'm going to select this face and send the cursor to the selected. I will change the origin. So right click, set origin, and origin to 3D cursor. So now I'm going to press Shift and S and send the cursor to the world origin, and Shift and S again and send this selection to the cursor. So now this will be our origin at the bottom, and let's start modeling now. So I will select the top face in edit mode, press G and Z to move it on the Z axis, minus 0.5. Just to have the half of it, and we are going to extrude by 0.5 every time. So now let's press I to insect. Let's press 0.02, enter, E to extrude again on 0.5, or let's extrude by 1. Insect once again, so I 0.02, extrude by 1. So this is what we need for now. I will now press Ctrl and R and add two loops at every part here. So to here and to here, and I will start giving some materials on this. So let's go to material tab, create a new one. This one will be an orange, so let's change the color, the base color here, to an orange one. I will also change the view to the viewport shading. I would like a nice orange. So this is it. And now I will create here a new material, which be a golden like, and also a white. These will be the stripes. So we have the white and the golden stripe. And I will also extrude so another time to create a white, a gold, a white, and the gold stripes. So insect by 0.2, extrude by 1, and add another two loops here. So select here the face selection, double click to select the entire loop, and assign here the white stripe. Here will be the golden one. So let's change the color to be a nice golden one. So make it a bit darker maybe. Here the white, and here is the gold. So this is it. I would like to scale it a bit to the Z axis, so press S and Z to scale it on the Z axis, maybe somewhere here. And also I will add a base here. So I will press Ctrl R to add one more loop at the bottom. Face selection, select the entire one with double click, E to extrude and S to scale, and scale around here. So this will be the base. So I'm adding a new material here, which will be the base, and the base color will be a black one. So let's double click to select this entire faces, also shift and double click here, shift double click and select also this one, select the base material and click on assign to assign it. So this is what we need. Now we will press Ctrl R here to create a lot of loops. Let's say something like 15 loops will be okay. And now I'm going to select this one. So double click with edge selection, double click to select this whole loop of edges and leave one back and select the other one until here. Press G on the Z axis to move them down and bring them somewhere here. Control B to add the bevel at these loops, and this is it. So now let's add also something on the top. I will double click here and press B to bevel it. Bevel it here with, let's say, two bevels. And also add a handle at the top. So for the handle, I will create a plane rotated at the X axis by 90 degrees. G on the Z axis, move it somewhere here. Scale on the X to fit where the width we need to be. And start modeling this one. So press Tab for edit. Select this edge, G on the Z axis, and bring it here. Now I will press A to select all the faces, which is one, which is a plane here. Shift and S, cursor to the selected, Tab to go back to object mode, set origin and send it to the 3D cursor. Now the cursor is here. It's also at the middle, the plane. So press 1 on the numpad to go to front view. And let's model this one. So I will select the vertex selection, select only these two vertices. Press S to scale on the X axis to bring them somewhere here. And I will add two more loops and scale them on the X axis to move them. Control R to add also another loop here. And select this face X and delete this face. So if you go now and press A to select everything, E to extrude and extrude it somewhere here. So this is the handle. I will also apply the orange material. So from the materials tab, open the drop down and select the orange one. And how you gonna add it to the exact middle? Let's hide this one. So select and press H on the keyboard to hide it. Select this one, Tab to go to edit, select these two faces, Shift and S, send the cursor to the selected, right click in object mode and set the origin to the 3D cursor. Now let's press Alt and H to unhide everything. I will select the base one, select this face, and press Shift and S and send the cursor to the selected. So now the cursor is at the middle of this face. And if we select this one and press Shift and S and send the selection to the cursor, it will be moved at the exact middle. I will also break it a bit down, so G and Z, just not to have any holes there. And that's it, guys. So I will select everything, press Ctrl J to join them together. And now I will add a modifier, which will be the subdivision surface, about one subdivision, just to make it smooth. Right click and shade smooth. So now here I will press Ctrl R to add some more loops, add one here, add also another one here, and repeat the process. And now let's add loops to the handle. Press press G on the x-axis to move it, send the cursor to the word origin, and let's create the second one. So the second one, it will be something similar to this, but this time it's the ones with the water filled in them. So let's create another cylinder, start from this, selecting the bottom face, so face selection, send the cursor to the selected, change the origin, send the cursor to the word origin, and the selected to the word origin. I will select this face, bring it down a bit. Actually, I will bring it and start from the base this time. So, insect, somewhere here, one for front view. E to extrude, extrude it here. S to scale, scale inside. E to extrude, extrude inside, extrude again, extrude once again, S to scale, bring it back, E to extrude, scale, scale it around here. I will double click to select all the loop here and scale to bring it somewhere here because I didn't like it. And that's it more or less. I should have a cap on top, so I'm going to create also the cap. It will be a black one, a black cap. So let's press E to extrude, extrude somewhere here. Double click these faces, E to extrude, leave it at the same position, S to scale, scale around here. And the cap, I will scale somewhere here. Press E to extrude. Actually, I will press G and Z to extrude it more. And press S to scale somewhere here. Now we'll select all one by one these faces. I will press E to extrude, press G and Z axis, so I will extrude them here. I select this face, press E to extrude, and extrude it somewhere here. So this is the cap. Let's press Shade Smooth and add the subdivision surface to one subdivisions. And let's start adding loops. This is just to create some hard edges. And add here the materials also. So I'm going to create here the yellow material. Create a nice yellow one, a bit of orange. This is the material that we need, and also for the cap, it will be the base that we created for the other one. So let's press one on the numpad, go to wireframe, B for box selection, and select this stuff here in face selection. Let's go back, wireframe, B. And until here, also these faces here, create a new material and add the base and assign. So now if we go here, this should be. Okay, we have to apply also the modifier. Select this entire one and change to yellow, and this is what we need. So moving also this one on the x-axis, we can scale it a bit just to have a nice size between our objects. And let's now create a new barrier, which be will be the small ones for the parking lots. So create another one time, a cylinder, scale it. I will scale it to here. Select this one, cursor to the selected, set the origin here to the words, and the selection to the word. And let's start modeling the base as before. E to extrude, S to scale. Scale around here. Get this one. Press I to insert. It's adjust a bit and extrude. So let's press one of the numpad. G on and Z to extrude on the Z axis. I will bring it somewhere here. I'm good with it. So B to bevel a bit here. And now I will add a loop at the center just to split the difference. And here I would like three stripes, so should be six cuts. Leave them at the exact same position. Press S to scale on the Z axis and scale them somewhere here. G on the Z and bring them a bit up. So this is for the stripes. I'm gonna add the material. So I will like the yellow one, and also create a new and add the base here. These stripes will be black. So select the stripes, change to black, and also the bottom part. This also here, the edge, and this change to black and assign. So this is for this one. I'm gonna add the loops from now before adding the subdivision. We know that we need the hard edges, so just for the edges, G on the Z and bring it here, and that's it. So I will select this face, press I to insert, X to delete this the face, select the vertices here, Alt M and match them at the center. Same for the bottom part, select this one, X faces, the entire vertices here, Alt M at the center. So let's press on Shade Smooth. As you can see, we don't need actually a subdivision surface modifier. It's already good. We can add some more loops. So in G and Z to bring this down. Also one here and one here. So it's already looking nice. The next thing that we need is the bolts. So I'm adding a cylinder. Let's change here to six vertices, hexagonal, and apply by clicking outside. So select it again, scale, G on the Y, scale, three, scale, G on the Z, and bring it here. So these are the bolts. So I'm going to create a new material now, which will be the bolts. And this one is just a gray color. So let's press now right click and set the origin to the 3D cursor in order to be at the middle of the world origin. Press Shift and D to duplicate, leave it at the same position. Rotate on the Z-axis by 180. So let's select both of them, Shift and D, rotate on the Z 100. Actually, it's 90 degrees. And let's also press another one time, Shift and D, rotate on the Z 45 degrees. Select these two, rotate on the Z by 45. So this is with the bolts. Let's select everything here. Press Ctrl J to join them together. And that's it, guys. We created another barrier. G on the X to move it here. Let's move on with a cone now. So let's press Shift and A, add another one cylinder. This time, let's change here to 36. Select the bottom face, change the origin once again. So, sending the origin here, sending up. And now for the cone, we just need to select this, scale until here. So, select this edge loop, scale somewhere here. We have to delete these two faces and add a modifier here. It will be the solidify one to add some thickness. Apply this one. Let's also add the loops that we need from now. So one loop, one inside. At the edges always. So one here, another one inside. And time to add the base now. So for the base, I'm gonna press Shift and A while we are in the edit mode and add a single plane. So for the plane, let's scale it until here. E to extrude, extrude it around here. Select the edges around. Press Ctrl B to bevel them. Add some more loops. And that's it pretty much. We can select just a single face and press L to select everything on the objects on the faces that are joined. So I will bring it a bit up. And that's it. So let's start with the materials. I will add the base one. This is for the base. Also, I will add a new one, the orange. Select all these faces until here. So this loop, this inside, select all of them, assign the orange one. We can always press on Shade Smooth and add loops here. This is what we need. Insect a bit. Also on this face, insect a bit. And I will now add some loops for the stripes. So I would like to have three of them. So one will be here. And two like this. So select all these faces. Add a new material, select the white one and assign. So this is for the cone. I will scale it somewhere here, J on the X to move it here. Next, it will be the concrete barrier. So for this one, I would like to add a cube. Bring the cube at the center. So I'm changing the origin once again, world origin selection here. Let's move them this more. So for this one, I would like to add a loop at the center and select all these faces and delete them. Now I'm gonna add a modifier. It will be the mirror one, just to edit the half of it. So I'm gonna move also this from here. And let's start modeling. So selecting these two faces, scale on the Y to bring them somewhere here. I would like a loop at the bottom, somewhere here. Also another loop here. And this is just scaling, so select these two, scale on the Y, bring them inside. And I will select all of these, G on the X, and create something like this. So I would like this to be thicker, so scaling here, also smaller here. And that's it, guys. For this one, we can add two loops here, bring them around the middle, and we can delete these faces to create a hole there. And by selecting these two edges, press F to fill them, and also F to fill this one side and this side. So this is good until now. Also, I would like to create two holes. So I will create a cylinder, rotate on the X axis by 90 degrees, scale it until here. I will add one, I think, at the middle of this one, and scale on the Y. So selecting this one and this one, and from the properties with the N here to the edit bool tool, and I will press difference with the brush boolean, so we can select this and move it where we want it. I think I'm good there, so I will apply the brush, select it, X and delete. This is what we need. Present to hide this. And here it will be the concrete, so the material will be concrete. Create a new one, I will name it like concrete, change to engrave one, and that's it. So we created five barriers here. That the next step is to unwrap them, export them, and create the textures in Samsas Painter. So now it's time to select everything and save it as a different file. So as you can see here, I saved all the barriers as different files. This is just to wrap everything differently and export it as a FBX file. So press tab for each model, select everything with A, U and Smart UV Unwrap. Let's go back to object mode and file export as FBX file, and let's repeat for the rest of them. So now let's go to Samsas Painter, press on file, new, and select this FBX file that you exported before. Press OK, and it will appear in the viewport. So now let's click on bake textures under texture set settings. So I will press bake textures, uncheck the normal and bake all the textures. And once it is finished, Let's switch to the shelf and go to smart materials, and I will add here the steel rust surface, but we are going to remove the metallic thing in order to create a concrete like smart material. So I will drag this to the layers. It will automatically be added to the barrier here. And let's open this folder, and let's go to the base metal and uncheck the metal. Also, I will uncheck the roughness, or maybe let's still stick with the roughness, but we can change it to something darker. Also, for the metal scratches, we can hide it just to see how it looks. We can then delete or remove these layers. We can play with the roughness in order to have something concrete. So I will like this one, and it's time to export the textures. So let's go to file and export textures. Let's export them at the texture and press on export. So everything now is finished, and time to continue with the rest of the items. So I will press File, New, discard this one or save it if you want it. I will continue with the big barrier, press OK to load it, bake the textures as we talked before, uncheck the normal and bake the textures. Once it's done, let's go back to the shelf, smart materials, and here, as you can see, for this one that we have more materials applied, they are listed here to the textures list. We have the base, the gold, the orange and the white. So I will start with the orange one. I will try to find the plastic here. So we have a glossy plastic that we don't need. We have this dirty scratched plastic, that is all we want. Let's now expand this and select here the base plastic to change the color. So the base color should be the orange one that we want. And also let's change these damages, so if we can remove them and then leave only the scratches with the dirt. I prefer it like this, so I'm going to remove this edge and damages. So I'm going to remove these layers, and now moving on with the white one, I'm going to add this one again, expand and remove the edge damages just to have the same feeling for the whole object. So I'm removing this. Let's go to the golden one, apply this, remove the edge damages, and change the base color to a golden now. So maybe this one looks good. And for the base, we can apply this one again, remove the edge damages layers, and change the color here to a black one. But as you can see, this is not a nice orange, so let's go back to the orange base plastic and change the orange material here from here. So I would like it to be more red, so something like this. This is perfect for me. So let's export these textures also. I'm exporting the textures and export. Once we are finished, let's go to the new one. I will discard this one, select the new FBX file, the water barrier, open that one, click OK, bake the textures, uncheck the normal, and bake all the textures. Once we are done, switching to the shelf, small materials, and let's add this plastic one again for the base. As you can see, I have selected the base. The base is the cup for this one, so removing the edge damages once again. Change the color to a black. We can always save this. We can change the name to plastic dirty and export it once again. So we have the plastic dirty now. We can use this every time. So if we go to the yellow, we are using the plastic dirt, so we don't have the edge damages, but we only need to change the base plastic color. So let's change this to a yellow one, so something like this. I will also save this one by changing its names to a plastic dirty yellow, and create small material. This can be the plastic dirty black in order to use them once again after that. So I will go to export the textures once again. Once we are done, let's continue with the other one, which will be the cone barrier. Okay, bake textures, uncheck the normal bake all textures, and once textures are done, we are going now to use the same material. So for the base, I need the plastic dirty black, which is already done. For the orange, I'm going to get the yellow and change the base color to an orange one. And for the white, I'm going to use the yellow and change the base color to the white. So let's export this again, textures. And last one is the parking lot barrier. So let's select this one, press OK to open it, bake the textures, uncheck the normal and bake all texture set. So for this one, we have the base, which will be the black that we created. We have the yellow, and now for the bolts, let's use this rusted one, and we are also done with this. So export the textures, and now moving back to Blender, we are going to add the textures for just a single barrier that we created. I'm not gonna repeat the same process for all these objects, but it will be the exact same process with just the textures for each model from the folder that we had. So for, let's say for this one, the concrete one, we are going to the shading from here, and let's find our textures while we save them. So I will select desktop, open the concrete barrier folder, and the base, height, metallic and sidereal textures are included for each object to repeat the process. So I'm going to select the base color, add it here, and connect the base to the base of the principal BSDF. So the nodes will be the exact same for all the models. Let's get the height, add it here, press Shift and A, and add a math node for this one. Add the color to the second value and the value to the displacement. Change to 0.2 and change to multiply. Let's see how it looks. As you can see, it's a nice there with 0.2. Don't increase it, it will look ugly. So now let's take the metallic and connect it to the metallic. This is the ambient occlusion. Ambient occlusion is usually connected with the base color. So let's add a RGB mix and connect these two. So I will add also this one here and change to multiply. I will leave it to 0.5 Next is the normal map. Let's drag it here at the bottom. Shift and A, search for embump node. Add the color to the head of the embump and the normal to the normal of the principal BSDF. Strength 2.2 again. And the last is the roughness. So I will move it here and connect the color to the roughness of the principal BSDF. And that's it pretty much. We can add a color ramp. Let me move this here. And press Shift and A, search for a color ramp and add it to the roughness. And this is to control the power of the roughness. So by decreasing the white to the left, we are controlling the roughness. This is the final render with all the five barriers that we modeled and textured. It took a long to finish, but it was five models at a single tutorial. So if you like the video, press the like button, leave a comment below, and if you are new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe.